Hello. Hi guys, welcome back to The Roach Show, and today, it's a bit of a weird one. It's a very, really, really weird day. I haven't done a video talking to the camera in a while. It's been a quick minute, but basically I have a new setup today. If I zoom out my lens a bit more, you can't see it, but I have a boom. I have a boom mic. It's a big boy. I don't know if this sounds awful, or actually I need to change it. Because then I can get closer to it. Hey, how's it going? Today I'm going to be talking about the 10 best films on Netflix. I've never used one of these before. It's not a microphone. I've used a microphone. Never used it on a pole. Hey guys, welcome back to The Roach Show. And today I am going to be talking about the 10 best films on Netflix because, you know, it's quarantine time. I can't leave the house, apparently. Great being asthmatic. Thanks, lungs. You're doing a great job there, buddy. So films are very important. They can represent cultures. They can represent a time zone. They can tell stories that, you know, no other medium can capture as well as films. Films have lasted for, you know, centuries. I mean, we've seen the golden age of Hollywood, the French New Wave, Czech New Wave, European New Wave, British New Wave. One thing that still remains is that films allow us to see the lives through other people's perspectives. It allows us to see stories that may be true or maybe completely fictional, transport us to worlds that, you know, we would never be able to see, and allows us to escape for at least like 2 hours or something. You know, seems quite reasonable in a time like this that we'd want to escape. Recently, we've seen the rise of screaming services. Streaming services. We've seen the rise of streaming services such as Netflix, Amazon Prime. These just allow us to access film, TV and other stuff way more easier. That's why they're important. That's my point. It's important. It's important. We're all trapped kind of inside our house. As some of you may know, I'm a film student. Well, not anymore. I've got my A-levels apparently. Who knows really? I have no clue. Anyway, I'm a film student. So basically that means my opinion is better than yours. Everyone knows this. Okay, we can just move past this point. But seriously, a lot of people have been asking me what's the best thing to watch on Netflix. I thought it'd be a good idea. I've done a video like this before, like last year, but I feel like having a new one because Netflix have kind of been like films. Have our film. Take them. You want them. You do. You want them. It's only a short list. I'm going to keep this short and sweet just because, one, I can't be asked to edit like a full feature-length film about other films. Fun fact, this hat only cost me £2 and I do not regret it at all. Okay, so number one, we have, what's on the list? Birdman. So I'm going to take this off and look like an absolute, oh crap, I broke it. I think I've broken the £2 hat already. I'll fix it off. The camera's still rolling. So Birdman's a great film. It's Michael Keaton's in it, Emma Stone, Edward Norton, anyone you can think of. It's an international director. It means you get kind of new spin on classic Hollywood films. It's a really nice twist. All done in one take. Basically the story of Michael Keaton after he did the Batman films, he went on to the next stage of his career. But it's about this guy who decides to open up a show in Broadway. It always takes place in New York and it'll blow your head in some very, very weird bits, but just beautiful cinematography that will just take your breath away. So if you want to escape for a bit and just see another story, do it and you'll just be amazed. Number two is Scott Pilgrim vs. the World. I think I've said about this in like every other video about film. Brilliant film, directed by Edgar Wright, Michael Cera, Brie Larson, anyone you can think of. Like, it works both ways. You can sit down and watch it and be like, ah, that's a good film, that was good, I like that. Or you can sit down and be like analysing it because there's so much stuff in it. So many things that I'm still noticing like, after rewatching it. So I really want to know what your opinion about it. So if you have seen the film, what do you think? Because I know a lot of people react to it differently. Anyway, number three is quite a common one. La La Land. I know everyone's like, watch La La Land. I rave about it. It's kind of like love or hate. I really like it. I think the star is brilliant. You know, a lot of people have been saying that problems with the dancing. Personally, I don't think that's a problem with the film. I just think Damien Chazelle is a great director. Another film to watch. I'm not sure if it's on Netflix anymore. The reason why I didn't put it on the list, because I don't think it is, his earlier film Whiplash. Watch it if you can in this break and you'll want to watch it again. I've watched it twice in one day. It is so good. I forgot the name of it. Number four is the Holy Grail, Monty Python. They're just crazy. If you've never seen Monty Python stuff, you're going to be in for a joyride. So it's the crazy story behind this film. People like Elton John and George Harrison funded it. If you're not aware of Monty Python, they also have Flying Circus on Netflix, as well as Life of Brian, one of their other films. But it's so hard to explain. It's just classical British comedy, effects, improv. There's shots where it shows the whole production team. It's so wild. And it's quite Dadaist, something that I've been studying recently. It's very interesting. I'll let you discover Holy Grail for yourself. Number five is a very important film. I feel like it's films that can make you a better person. On number five on the list is Groundhog Day, starring Bill Murray. I just dropped the pad. I wouldn't say it's the best film ever. I feel like there is definitely some flaws with it, but still, I think it's the message behind it. Like Karate Kid, Breakfast Club, Ferris Bueller's Day Off, all of those films, I think they all come under a bracket that I think people should watch more of, and they really have like a really good undertone to the story. Yeah, Groundhog Day is definitely a good way to start. Coming in at number 6, we have one of the first international film on the list. This is Spirited Away. I haven't watched too much Studio Ghibli in my time, but this is the first one I've seen. I love this film. It's mental, but you may watch it, and the art style is beautiful. Beautiful shots. It's just crazy. Afterwards, you'll just be thinking, wow, what the fuck did I just watch? Brilliant. It's lovely. And it really makes me want to visit Japan and witness their culture, because I feel like Japanese culture is very, very cool. Watch it. I can't really say much about it because I don't know a lot about Studio Ghibli. So number 7 is another international film. This is City of God, made by Morales. I used to have to study it until my exams got cancelled. This film, made in Brazil, 2002. It's about favelas in Brazil, the segregation and gang violence within the community and how it develops. It just... the opening will have you hooked. Number 8 is Adam Sandler in general.
Adam Sandler. Andy Samberg. Wayne The Rock Johnson.
Uncut Gems. Yeah, it's made by the Safdie brothers. It's been in the works for like 10 years. I feel like it's a different, because I'm so used to seeing it. My guilty pleasure is Adam Sandler's, you know, rom-coms. I feel like they're the only films where I can kind of like turn off. It's bad. I enjoy them. Seeing Adam Sandler in a different setting with, you know, very serious dark tones, but just like the little details in the film will have you going crazy, and great setting of New York. So watch Uncut Gems. If you're feeling something a bit on the lighter side, I will suggest Just Go With It, as well as 50 First Dates. 50 First Dates, I would happily say, is actually a good film with a good plot, even if it is ridiculous. Number 9 is kind of a joint one between films that people probably have watched, but they haven't watched it entirely. So under this bracket comes Superbad, Grand Budapest Hotel. Both films are incredible and they're referenced everywhere. Grand Budapest Hotel, if you love films, it's definitely the film for you. If you're looking for something to just enjoy, Bad is more of like the typical type of comedy. Imagine a good version of the American Inbetweeners. Like, if they actually made the American Inbetweeners good, this is what it would be like. And number 10 will absolutely mess with your head, and this is Looper. It's kind of gone under the radar, as well as, I think, in this category also fits like Knives Out. Like, the really, really, really good films. Oh, it's an odd category. It's a time travel film, and it will hurt your brain, but in a good way. So that's my video for today. I'm sorry if I do ramble on a bit. I'm just trying to give you as much films to watch, because I feel like now's the perfect time to watch film. So make sure you subscribe, hit that like button, and tell me what you want next, because I have a lot of time on my hands. I want to make more videos. So yeah, comment.